particle size distribution. It is one of the major factor in the powder metallurgy technique. The question is, why the particle size it matters? The main characteristics which is required for the particles is nothing but the size, shape, dimensions. As we know that in the powder metallurgy technique, the compaction as well as sintering is a two process which is a main essential to achieve a good component. In this case, the particle size matters. The characteristic techniques, the chemical composition and the structure, the level of the impurities element in the metallic powder can be verified significantly, both the processing and as well as the properties of the final product. It is necessary to know whether such elements are present in the elements or not. The effect of the impurity of the element depends upon the hardness of the particle and as well as the degree of the chemical reactivity during the sintering process. The microstructure of the crystalline powder has a significant influence on the behavior of the powder during the compaction as well as the sintering. The fine grain size is always desirable as it improves the mechanical property. The grain size can be depends upon the powder size particle. The particle powder produced, either it may be mechanical or by chemical, the particle size it matters. The micro porosity associated and entrapped gases in the process is also one of the important characteristics in densifying in the compaction and as well as in the sintering stages. The shape of the powder is characterized by dimensionality of the particle and the contour surface. Most of the powder particles are three-dimensional in nature. They are considered as being somewhat equiaxial. Spherical particles represent a simplest and ideal example of the particle shape. Porous particles differ from irregular one because of the presence of porosity, which itself may be a very irregular in both size and as well as the shape. The large amount of porosities makes the shape characteristics very difficult. The unimodal distribution, where a high point or the maximum amount of some critical size is essential. The sketch or the distribution of the particle size and as well as the weight size is represented in this slide. Now, SEM is the microscopic, which is nothing but a optical microscopy or scanning electron microscopy, which is used to find out the size of the particle. Inter-particle friction and as well as flow characteristics. The friction between the particle affects the ability of the powder flow readily and pack tightly. The common test of the inter-particle friction is the angle of response, which is the angle formed by piling off the powder as they are poured from a narrow funnel. Smaller particle size generally greater friction and steeper angle. The spherical shapes and the lowest interparticle friction. As the shape deviates from spherical, the friction between the particle tends to increase. This schematic diagram shows the funnel and as well as the pile of the powder. The angle of response decides how the particle size is. The compressibility. Compressibility is the measure to which the powder will compress or dense upon the application of the external force. Now, compressibility of the powder is influenced by factors like inherent hardness of the metal, particle shape, porosities, particle size distribution, and presence of non-metallic materials which is used in the alloying materials. The addition of other alloying elements either maybe a solid lubricants. The compressibility is a general increases with increasing apparent density. Rather, a large amount of densification occurred at relatively low compression pressure. Particle size. The most common method uses screens the different meshes by a mesh count. The mesh count of a 200 means there is a opening of 200 in a linear inch. Higher the mesh count means the smaller the particle size. This slide shows the section of the wire screen, which is nothing but a two wires which are arranged perpendicular to each other, forming a mesh. The size and as well as the screen opening is representing the size of the particle that which can pass through it. The measurement of the powder particles. If the size of the particle is very small, then it will pass through the mesh, and then that mesh size number defines the particle size. If the particle is not passing through it, that which is in staying as a residue, that depicts the mesh size also. The powder structure. There are various shapes of metal powders are available in the process. The first one, the spherical, second one rounded, third one angular, fourth one acicular, fifth one dendritic, sixth one flakes, seventh one porous, eighth one irregular, ninth one fragmented. The particle shape has pronounced effect on the packing of the powder and has an influence on its compacting and sintering property and the mechanical strength of the component. For that reason only, the particle shape matters a lot in the process. The shape of the powdered particles. First one is spherical shape, rounded shape, angular shape, spongy, flaky, cylindrical, acicular, and as well as cube. In the previous slide, what we had discussed is the different types of the particle shapes. Now, in this slide, what we are discussing is the same along with the particles, how it is. Chemical characteristics. The chemical characteristics of the particle that it can be measured by using so many different methods. The first one is XRD, IDAX. Powder shaping or the particle packing modification. Packing factor is equal to bulk density by the true density. Packing can be increased by vibrating the powder, causing them to settle more tightly. Pressure applied during the compaction greatly increases the packing of powder through arrangement and deformation of the particle. An understanding of the particle packing characteristics is more important in many diverse fields of technology, such as the solid state fuel packing for the rocket and as well as missiles in aeronautical industries. For example, if the particle size is too big, the void between the particles is also more. If the particle size is small, the void between the particles will also small. Powder compaction and the process variables like pressure, density and distribution and compaction. Compacting is the technique that converting loose powder into a compact accurately defined to the shape and size of the component which is required. Conventional compaction method is by pressing, which is opposing punch squeezing the powder contains in the die. This is carried at room temperature in the dies by the pressing machine. The press used for compacting either it may be mechanically or by means of hydraulically. The die consists of cavities, where the metal powder is poured into the die cavity and pressure is applied by moving the punch. Dies are usually made up of high grade steel, or even sometimes carbide dies are also used for the application. The compacting process, the pressure applied should be uniform and applied simultaneously from the above and as well as below. The pressure applied should be high enough to produce a cold welding of the powder. Isostatic pressing. What is isostatic pressing? Isostatic pressing is the powder metallurgy forming a process that applies an equal pressure in all direction on the powder compact, thus achieving the maximum uniformity and as well as the density and the microstructure without the geometrical limitations and uniaxial pressing. Isostatic pressings are of two types. The first one is nothing but the cold isostatic pressing. The another one is the hot isostatic pressing. The cold isostatic pressing is used, or it is working under room temperature, where the temperature is not the parameter. But in the case of the isostatic pressing, the temperature is the matter, that too especially elevated temperatures. Now the powder metallurgy parts requires a pressure which is applied in a flexible mode. Even the pressure and as well as the density distribution matters to get a complex shape. Hot isostatic pressing schematic diagram is shown in this slide. Hot isostatic pressing involves applying the pressure and temperature simultaneously so that the molding and as well as sintering, or the compaction and sintering of the powder, takes place at the same time in the die. The time is one of the major factor that is helpful in the hot isostatic pressing. Higher the temperature, where the time is shorter. The time is shorter. Die material includes either it may be a steel, or it may be a graphite, or even it may be a ceramic. High speed steel may be used for shorter times at 600 degrees centigrade. The graphite for 700 up to 3000 degrees centigrade. However, graphite dies are limited to pressure of 140 kgs per centimeter square. The advantages of the hot pressing: reduction in gas content and shrinkage effect. High strength can be achieved, and also the hardness can also be achieved very easily in this process. The densification is higher, and the components what we are obtaining is of the sound and high compacted. Hot pressing break down an oxide film and exposes a fresh surface finish. The main disadvantage of the hot pressing is high die cost, and pressure takes a considerable time to complete the process. The application of the hot pressing. Hot pressing is used for the production of a very hard cemented carbide cutting tools. Cold isostatic pressing and hot isostatic pressing advantages. The uniform strength in all the directions can be achieved in this process. The densification of the powder is also uniform in this process, which resulting in compact piece where will have a uniform shrinkage, and even the wrapping can also be minimized. The shape flexibility. Isostatic pressing makes its particle to produce the shape and as well as the dimensions that are difficult and impossible to produce in other methods. Component sizes. A wide range of component sizes can be used to achieve the components accurately and with dimensional accuracies. Large parts, the parts size are limited only by the size of the isostatic pressure chamber. Low tooling cost, for the shorter production run, the tooling cost is low in comparison to the other manufacturing method. Reduced lead time, the complex shapes can be economically made from a prototype to production quality, which significantly reduce in the lead time versus the forging.